Lil E.
What's happening, baby?
Welcome to Live with Steve Lobel.
Oh, yeah, all the time.
Well, welcome home.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah.
I heard you just came out the county.
Yeah, before the movie came out, yeah.
Real recognized real.
Yeah, yeah.
And off the camera, you told me you ran the show.
Yeah, I seen him in there. He's don't look too good. I did about maybe like 4 or 5 months while he was going through that. You know, I sat in day rooms and watched it all on TV, the little movie scene or the commercial set. And like, oh, he's finna come in here. And then had a little, when he went to visiting, we were coming. He's just on high power. So me being in GP, we had the general population, we had to turn and face the wall because they, they're high security individuals.
Isn't that crazy? Like you were in the county jail, LA County.
Yeah.
The movie's about to come out.
All that, man.
And obviously everybody knows this, but Death Row and Ruthless had beef. And you were in the county jail, like if he wasn't in PC and you guys could have bumped heads, could have been good or bad.
Hey,
could have kept that,
all the way,
beef
all the way.
Going, right?
Real talk.
And that would have made
real
some stories,
talk.
Right?
That would have had the county turned up.
Right, you had the county turned up. You know what's so crazy sitting here and talking to you because I know you for a long time.
Yeah.
And your pops was my man, rest in peace. Mm-hmm. And I'm so glad that Straight Out of Compton came out and it gave your dad his props because he was that man. He was that G. He was the businessman. He was the marketing genius.
Real talk.
He was the money man. He was the real guy. You know
real
what I mean?
Talk,
and I got the crazy story before we go into the interview deeper, but when he ran into Ice Cube in New York at the tunnel, he had brought Bone Thugs to New York for the first time. And Thuggish Ruggish was blowing up.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, let's go out. So he went to the tunnel. We ran the Cube. I didn't know what was going to go down, but I'm ready to pop it off.
Yeah.
And the Samoans were there, the twins. And
Jake and John, yeah.
Jake and John, shout out to them. And then we ran into LL Cool J that night and Funkmaster Flex. And then, obviously, he said he's going to walk back to the hotel. He had his Pendleton on, flannel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And he just walked back to the hotel, and it was freezing. I said, get in the limo. He said, I'm going to walk. And, I never saw him again. But hell of a man.
Yeah.
Great guy,
appreciate
visionary.
That.
So,
appreciate that.
You know, let's just go all over the place. How did you feel about Straight Out of Compton?
I like the question. It's a question I tell everybody. It's just a thin line with me being a son, It's like, you ask, your boy, you have one, you're blessed with one, God forbid, And I'm like, Lil Steve, how you like this? Pops was it, Pops was the man. Pops knew some people, Pops did this. So, it's tough asking me that, It was a great movie, It's just being a son, you want him just put out in the right sense on every level, but it's Hollywood, but it was a good movie though.
Yeah, I felt like 90% of the movie was real.
Yeah, which is entertainment, man.
Right.
That's what it is.
But like I said, I'm glad that they gave props to Ruthless and for your dad.
Yeah.
If Pops popped up right now, what's the conversation? If Eazy-E walked in right now, what's the conversation?
Man, I miss you, Damn, you missed this, that, this happened, that happened. Life, Grandpa's gone, Your daddy, his daddy, my father's daddy. So more so just maybe tears and hugs, I miss you.
Got you. Do you think Ruthless Records should come back?
Yeah, got to, Got to. Compton's put back on the map. Like I said, we got this resurgence of just Pop's legacy, It need to hit home, now, Just give it a try, put something out.
Did anybody ever know why he called it Ruthless Records?
Define him, His lifestyle at the time, Pops came up tough, And some born and raised in Compton, man, you just gotta be kind of cutthroat and ruthless, man. You just, gotta be hard.
When your dad Eazy passed away, you were 10 years old.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How did you feel and how did you raise yourself or did you have a mentor? Did you have someone help you out?
Man, it was tough. It was crazy because, being the first born and just having somebody that was really a father, it was hard. So my pain kind of went towards, and I was raised by his mother and father, so my grandparents. And raised me right just like they raised him, seen similarities and told me these stories and witnessed things that we both went through at the same time. And born and raised in the same house, Compton, off of Greenleaf. And I stepped off the porch. We buried him April 7th, I turned 11 April 23rd, and that's when I stepped off the porch. That's what we call it. I hit the streets, you know what I mean? And I chased individuals and, you know, his generation or close to it or his little homies, like, you know, as far as Steve's age and generation, and kind of look for stories and look for guidance and things like that. And you only pick up, being smart, a smart kid, kept me in a good school. Being smart, you picked up on the ones that kind of stayed in the game, hustling for a long time, stayed out of jail, you know what I mean, or kind of tough around here. So, you know, my only adaption is this home, you know. I'm a chill with Steve boy. Me and him gonna run the streets together now, and we finna go just tear stuff up. And my anger made it, you know, much easier that we see the wrong individuals across the street, let's go do something. All right, let's go. You know, so I was kind of, it was a rage, you know what I mean? So that's where the hardcoreness of growing up in Compton, California came from, you know, losing my father.
Right, so you just come out of the county jail. Mm-hmm. Is the number love in there for you?
Oh, most definitely, most definitely. You had to put it, I had to turn back the time to 18 years old, you know what I mean? You had to, it's glad, go back to gladiator school, you know, it's tough, man, you know what I mean? So, you know, it's a lot of where you from, you know what I'm saying? Who are you, where you from, where you is, you know what I mean? But when I felt like it would have been more than what it turned out to be, you know what I mean? It's just really, love came up, and it really kind of goes and defines from this man, you know what I mean? It shows how much respect my father got, you know what I mean? I did what I did in the streets, got my respect and everything, but it's never as big as the individual that, you know, I'm doing this for. And Pop's respect went a long line to where, you know what I mean? I went into one dorm and had three or four fades finna come at me, you know what I mean? And had a partner of me that we rode with each other from, you know, Twin Towers back to the county, like, now we finna do it with each other. You know, come back and, you know, you from Compton and start to look and, you know, what they call you? Man, you sure do look like Lil Eazy, man. And that's where the love came, you know, and that all comes from my father's name, so.
Isn't it crazy how, I mean, it's not crazy, but the impact that he made from the jails to the corporate world.
All the way, all
the
way.
Seeing the movie do all those numbers.
Yeah, yeah.
How did you feel about that?
Yeah. Real good, you know what I mean? It let the world know as far as what, you know, this little short man from Compton, California, you know, set an impact on the world. And you know what I mean? Something that you're related to is at the time of his passing, he didn't even know as far as how much more with the group Bone Thugs and Harmony. You
right.
know what I mean? You know, like Steve could tell you, you know, Pops was on his deathbed with the album. You know what I mean? And his belief in them, you know, he didn't get to see really a surge to what he really felt they were. You know, Grammy, you know, they would, next to NWA, that's the greatest.
Bone Thugs and Harmony, yeah.
Greatest rap group.
Woke up quick at about noon, just thought that I had to be in Compton soon. I gotta get drunk before the day begins, before my mother starts bitching about my friends.